India and abroad. His areas of expertise are varied, ranging from sustainable development, climate finance, responsible investments, integrated reporting management, circular economic finance, weather derivatives, circular economy finance to public management, CSR, strategic management, sustainability and creativity, valuation of intangibles, and so on. He is a regular expert advisor to IFSC, World Bank, Government of India sponsored research projects. He has developed housing finance models for the poor in Bangladesh and Nepal and a business model for utilizing biodiversity of the Cooperative Republic of Guyana, South America. He is also an EU expert on circular economy, finance, and recently conducted a workshop on the same at Bangkok's Chulalongkorn University. He is on UGC Bangladesh panel of experts for university accreditation. We welcome you, sir. We have Dr. Seema Sharma, HOD IIT Delhi, Department of Management Studies. Dr. Seema Sharma is faculty in the area of economics and statistical analysis in the Department of Management Studies at IIT Delhi. She is the chairperson of economics area in the department. Her research areas include sustainable development, socioeconomic analysis, productivity and efficiency analysis, and energy economics. She has been awarded with Outstanding Young Faculty Fellowship Award by IIT Delhi for her contribution to teaching and research. She was conferred with the Best Professor in Economics Award by Hindustan Unilever BSA Divang Mehta Business School Award in 2012. Apart from consulting assignments, she has done research projects funded by government agencies such as Indian Council for Social Sciences and Research, ICSSR, Ministry of Environment and Forest, that is MOEF, and Khadi and Village Industries, KVIC. She is also working on sustainable development of rural India under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, an initiative by Ministry of Human Resource Development, that is MHRD. Welcome you, ma'am, here on the panel. We have Mr. Prashant Chauhan, experienced social worker faculty with a demonstrated history of working in the higher education and development sector. Skilled in community organization, corporate social responsibility operations management, event management, public speaking, and human resource management, strong community and social services, professional with a MSW focused in industrial relations and personnel management, and law graduate. We welcome you, sir, here. So here we had we have our jury members. I would want our first storyteller, and she is Miss Shilpa Shri, ma'am. Welcome you, ma'am. Good evening. And I would want to introduce you to the audiences and the jury members. The project name is Nursery Lives in Madhepura, Alstom. Shilpa Shri is a seasoned professional with over 17 years of expertise in directing organizations in the visioning of a brand strategy, CSR, and public affairs advocacy. Currently, she is director, communications, and CSR at Alstom. Prior to Alstom, she was with Renault Nissan, where she was heading communications and CSR. She has worked on leadership positions at Terex and Volvo. Once again, welcome you, ma'am. And you can start with your story, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Social Story. Thank you, Shweta. Namaste. Good evening to all the participants and also to the esteemed jury members. Can you hear me well?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Okay. So the next 10 minutes, I'm going to take you through what we are doing in a place called Madhepura in Bihar. But before getting on to the projects, I'll just give you an overall view of what, you know, Alstom does and what, you know, CSR for us is a piece in our whole sustainable mobility journey and in our aim to work towards a greener tomorrow, actually. So whether it is being able to develop products which are more eco-friendly, are more green for the future, or whether it's working on 100% electric supplied renewable energy used vehicles. So in the whole gamut of things, we ensure that we also include our suppliers, we include our employees, and of course, you know, work with the communities where we actually operate. Just to give you an overall view of where all we are actually active globally, we are active, you know, whether it's the COP24, whether it's the Hydrogen Council. In fact, Alstom has the distinction of building and running the first hydrogen train. You know, anybody would say it runs by water is what somebody would, you know, would like to say that. So we've leaped to that stage. That's the Dow Jones Sustainability Index, where we've got very good rating, or working with the Decarbonization Alliance globally. I think we are the only, I can say proudly that we are the only one in the railway manufacturing space which is actually there on these councils. That said, let me talk about our philanthropy wing, which is Alstom Foundation. So the foundation has been working for the last decade, working on in various countries. So we are present as a business in more than 60 countries, and the foundation, Manoj, maybe you will have to decrease the window of yours, which says socio story. You'll have to minimize. No problem. You'll have to just minimize it, because it kind of tends to blip there on top. So, yeah. So we work in most of all the countries where we operate locally. And globally, what we do is annually we open up for projects between Jan to June. And starting September, October, start awarding projects at various countries for execution.
It's the reverb. Yeah.
Yeah, I can just. Yeah, if you can just decrease that window of yours which says socio story.
Prajwal? Okay.
The small window of socio story, the black one that you all see. I mean, do you all see it? Because I see it on my screen.
And we can only see your screen, actually.
Perfect. Then great. Okay, fine. So, you know, coming to Madhepura. So, Madhepura is in Bihar. In fact, for anybody, like for anybody who's born and brought up in a city environment in India, to go in to see, we've seen a lot of villages, but Madhepura is a different ballgame altogether. One of the poorest districts, but thanks to some of the politicians who have grown up from there, the district was able to move on from being just known for poverty, for floods, for drought and situations like that, to becoming a centerpiece in the whole, you know, what Indian Railways calls as green railways, a whole piece in it. So from being one of the most backward districts, it today proudly is the home that is building India's most powerful, you know, 100% electric locomotive for the Indian Railways. So this was a joint venture way back in 2015 that Alstom and Indian Railways inked. The plan is for 800 locomotives to be built in the factory. You know, just imagine being in a village like that and suddenly 300 acres are getting converted. You're having cranes, trucks come in, building happening. There's a township right there inside. So the whole landscape in the last 4 years has changed for this district. And like just giving you some stats which are right there. The population is about 50,000 plus. Literacy rate is again at about 50%. The female-male ratio is not as bad, you know, 914 to 1,000. But the number of unemployed are more than 60%. Agriculture still is primary. I think a lot of the new generation and the youngsters have actually migrated out, either gone away to Patna, which is the closest, about 6.5 hours away, or mostly to Calcutta or beyond those places. So we've adopted and we work with 7 villages that are the ones which have actually given up land as well for the project where we operate, where the factory is operating. And we work on 4 pillars to be straight and you know, talk to you about. There's education, there's healthcare, women empowerment, and skilling. So in education, we're looking at children, mostly dropouts. The literacy rate isn't too great. We're looking at how we can get them back to schools. Healthcare is, you know, like I told, the place is drought affected. It's floods. April, May, I mean, it's crazy. You won't want to travel there. It's crazy hot, you know, for somebody who stays in Bangalore, like a person like me, it's going into a dead zone. That bad the situation is. Women empowerment, while the women there are, you know, like 900 to 1,000 as a ratio, but not much empowered, not much educated as well. And like I said, the children have mostly moved out. And skilling, because we built an ecosystem there, we are having a factory, it becomes very necessary that we help the students from that area to stay there rather than migrate out. The three NGOs that we work there in that space are Care India, there's the National CSR Network, and Pragya. So our interventions have been largely for the last 3 years, three and a half, just, you know, this year I'm really not counting because the last 6 months have been a little chaotic, except for COVID. We haven't been able to do much on, you know, what we deliver on ground. So talking about education, this is an overall slide that talks to you about what impact we see that has happened in the last 3 years. We see that about 90% of the children that we engage with have actually now are now actually showing interest, you know, and even the parents are allowing them to come and work with us. When I say work with us, in our, you know, we've got these mobile libraries, we've got these schools that run around. Over and above the schools that they actually go to, the situation of the government schools aren't too great there as well. So we've done some furniture work over there to see that, you know, the children get better infrastructure. We sensitize parents periodically on what they should be doing and how they should look at children and their, you know, in their future. We're looking at girls getting pushed a little more into higher education. And we also see that children, I think it's about consciousness, about their behavior, what they have to do. You know, they are learning a little more of it. One is to look at TV and movies and learn something, but the other one is to actually see people in your own environment and see how they're actually growing. Coming to this Mobile Vikas Kendra, it's actually a school that, you know, that runs across the seven villages. So it goes to various villages across during the week. And what we've noticed is that on cognitive skills, there's been about 95%, you know, the children who come and attend those schools. This is over and above school, their regular school. So they come there. I've gone and attended one of them. So, you know, on the half day that I went, very enthusiastic kids, always interested in knowing, you know, what is new. Language again. I don't know how many of you know here, but in Bihar, it's a norm. So every boy has a Kumar with his name and every girl has a Kumari. So anybody you say Shilpa Kumari, you know, Manoj Kumar, Chaitanya Kumari, Sagar Kumar. So, you know, that's the kind of names that they have. So once I did that pan and everybody had Kumar Kumari. So I told them, I asked people, what do you want to do? What do you want? The good thing is that today, I mean, you know, not degrading any profession, but gone are the days when somebody wanted to become, you know, look at somebody on TV and say, I want to become an actress or something like that. Today they aspire to become, I want to do medicine, I want to do doctor, I want to look at...
I'm sorry to disturb you. Do you want to show the presentation?
For me, the presentation is... I mean, I can see the presentation. So I'm just wondering if...
This is not being shared on the screen.
You have to share. Ma'am, you just have to click on share screen and then...
No, but were you not able to see the first screen also?
Yeah, we saw first screen. Post that, we couldn't see your screen actually.
Okay.
You can reshare it with you.
Okay. So share screen. I go to the desktop.
Yes.
Now can you see it?
Yes.
Sorry. Okay. Yeah. So you saw this slide before?
You'll have to share your entire screen. Right now you are specifically sharing a window. Cancel sharing and then click on sharing again. Click share screen again. Select the entire window.
Let me share for you, ma'am. Share.
I've shared the desktop and I've shared this. So I'm just wondering. Are you not able to see this?
Ma'am, I can share it.
Okay, I'll let you, Manoj. I'll let you, Manoj, do it immediately.
Ma'am, you need to stop.
I've stopped sharing. Yeah, you could go to the next slide.
Yeah.
Okay. So you did see this slide, right? The yeah. Madhepura one? The landscape of Madhepura?
Ma'am, there was no slide.
Till now, nothing was coming.
No.
Oh, wow. Okay. So sorry about that. So maybe you can just go slowly. I'll not talk, but then, you know, people can realize what is it that I was actually trying to show.
No problem.
So can you just go back? I want them to see the whole Madhepura scene, you know, because the whole idea was to show them that, not this, the slide number 5 probably. Yeah. So just stay here. This is where I was talking about how Madhepura has now moved from being one of the most backward districts to becoming home to the electric locomotive that's actually in Indian Railways now. Next one, Manoj. So the four interventions that we are actually working on are education, healthcare, women empowerment, and skilling. Next one, the three NGOs that we work with are Care India, National CSR Network, and Pragya. Education, coming to education. So this is where we've seen that, you know, children are actually inclined, parents are inclined these days to send. Initially, we had a problem. We had a problem getting the children because we were doing classes after, say, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, after they finished their regular school. So a lot of them were not coming in. But these days, we see more and more response from them. Next slide. Yeah, so this is a mobile Vikas Kendra, which is more like a library. It runs around the various, villages in the district, actually. And we've noticed that there is a marked improvement in the way children who come to these classes are actually responding on various of these topics, whether it's environment, whether it's reading and writing, whether it's English and Hindi speaking, or even reading. So you see that there's a marked improvement. There's a school called Holy Cross. Yeah, next slide, Manoj. There's a school called Holy Cross. Yeah. The previous one. Yeah. Okay. So there's a school called Holy Cross. This is the, I would say, the only formal English school actually available there. So what we've done is we've adopted that school and introduced smart classes. The girls do not have a toilet in that school. While it is a co-ed school, the girls do not have a toilet. So introduced that. The teachers are trained on smart classes. We also introduced water cooler and stuff like that, which is already not there. We also teach them about the rights for children and, you know, where they can go to come to know what rightfully should be theirs. Coming to the next vertical, which is healthcare. So in healthcare, what we've seen is that when we started the intervention, the government hospitals there aren't as good, you know, like I think that is the case with most hospitals in the world, India. So they needed a lot of infrastructure support, medicinal help for medicines. There are some private clinics as well there. So we started supporting. We had this mobile Kendra that went around. There was a health clinic that is there. We've got doctors who are positioned from our end. And we started doing interventions also at the schools that we work at. So that children started getting, you know, we changed the kind of food that one could get and buy at the shops there. You know, instead of biscuits, we kind of improved it to something which is more healthy. And Kushal Madhepura, which is a larger program. Kushal Madhepura spans around education, it spans around women empowerment, skilling, and also on healthcare. So in Kushal Madhepura, the women and the most of the women in the villages and the nurses who work there were actually trained on wash, on clean usage of hygiene. Coming to women empowerment, yeah. Just stay here, Manoj. Just stay on that slide.
Excuse me.
I know, Shweta, but I think it was a technical glitch, not my mistake. So yeah.
That's what I'm saying. I'm saying that you can take another a minute for you to complete it. But I think you. I think it will be done.
So 1 minute is unfair, Shweta. I'm not somebody who's going to say yes to everything. So I'm clear about that. Okay.
Okay.
Coming to women taking charge and women empowerment. We've seen, we do various sessions. We do, we've done these, like say, for example, in Anganwadis, there are 14 Anganwadis that cover those 7 villages. We've done hygiene sessions there. More than 300 women today are being benefited out of it. We've realized that with empowering the women, telling them about what it is, you know, what are their values given back to the society, attitudes towards the men, and the whole gender bias issue has actually decreased quite a lot. We see there's a marked improvement. When we do our sessions, we've had over 2000 plus people attend all our sessions on these. Disaster management, like I told you, because they have drought and flood almost on a yearly basis. So all that is something that we help them with as well. Coming to the last section, which is skilling. coming to the last section, which is skilling. Okay, so you can skip this because it's part of Kushal Madhepura. You can go to the next slide. Yes, okay. So coming here, so what we've done, no, the previous one, yes. To make people there, especially women and the young, the youth around there, self-reliant and help them not to move out of their existing, you know, home space. We've trained them on computer usage. We've given mobile repair trainings. Beauty and wellness and training and tailoring has been one big hit there. You know, I think there are a lot of girls who came forward to learn this. Basic accounting, a lot of them are looking at jobs. So today what happens is they aspire to work with us in our factory. And you know, when you tell them that, no, you need to have a certain level of education, you need to have certain level of exposure before getting it, that's when they're keen to actually learn, whether it's communication skills, whether it's computer classes. We also have organized jobs fair in the past. You know, about 70-75% of them actually got, almost all of them, 100% had got employment. But some of them decided not to pursue it later on because they had to move to another district. So they chose to stay there. So about 70-75% of them were all employed out of those, you know, in the job fair. More than 600 people have actually been given these vocational trainings, out of which a lot of them have become entrepreneurs, and we've got the banks to fund them for their small businesses. Next one. This is my last slide, which is on the adoption of the ITI there. This year it's going slow, but otherwise the plan is that there is an ITI right there. 2 years ago, we recruited about 50 ITI students into our factory. Today, they have become the face of Alstom over there. I think a lot of them are from the local villages. Everybody aspires to be like them. So we look forward to adopting that ITI, imparting training not only to the teachers, but also to the students. And all the girls in the ITI hall are part of the program. You know, we're doing it for mechanical and for electrical. For all the girls, it's about 150 of them. This year it's going slow because, you know, as you know, the educational institutions are closed, but we look forward to doing much more in the coming years. Like I said, it's just a start journey for us, and Madhepura has got a long way to go, and Ashram got a long way to go with them. So these have been our interventions. Open to any questions, or we take the questions at the end.
No questions will be coming directly to you. Thank you so much
Shilpa Shree ma'am, and it was really wonderful hearing you out. You're doing such wonderful job, and what I could make out from your story was, like, if I did not miss, like, education, women empowerment, skill, and healthcare. And it is lovely that the people out there in Madhepura, they are so fortunate to have been, I mean, these facilities, amenities you have been providing them. And I hope the best for Alstom also. And it was lovely hearing you, ma'am. We will be coming back to you for with the questions from the audiences. So
thank you.
So we had Shilpa Shree ma'am from Alstom. Now we have Mr. Prashant Shetty, our next storyteller. The project name is an Entrepreneurship and Employment Through Vocational Skills Training, and that is from Schneider Electric. Welcome you, sir, and you can start your storytelling, sir.
Visible now? Green?
Yeah, it is visible.
Yes, it is. Yeah. Hello all. Good evening. I am Prashant Shetty from Schneider Electric. Schneider India Foundation is an CSR arm of Schneider India Private Limited. We used to do all the CSR activity under the umbrella of Schneider India Foundation. Schneider India Foundation has different activities, like 5 pillars we have. 5 E's is called education, employment, entrepreneurship, electrification, emergency. These are the 5 E's activities. And today's story is about entrepreneurship and employment through the vocational skill training. Okay, skill building, it is one of the flagship program of Schneider India. Main objective of this program is to train underprivileged youth in the field of electricity, solar, and help them to gain employment or to start their own business. Achievement so far, Schneider is technology partner for 290 centers across India, across 29 states, with the 44 training partners. We have trained 1,27,000 plus candidates trained since the inception of the program in 2009, and we have trained 800 plus trainers till now. Skill development program outcomes. 70% of trained students were employed up post training, and their average salary is 8,500. And out of this, 5% trained student they are become entrepreneur. This is a footprint of our training program across India. As I mentioned, 1,27,000 plus youth train. We have maximum. We have training center in 29 states, barring to few states in northeast. And our major strategies: we are the technology partner of these centers and partner like Don Bosco and other corporate foundations. There are three pillars of the program. We have state of art solar, state of art electrical and solar center, COE for the trainers, and EDP entrepreneurship development program. Okay, I think skill training engagement model. Schneider India Foundation working as knowledge partner, and we have operational part for education. As a knowledge partner, our role is providing state of art training facility and training of their trainers, employment support, and subject matter expert for the as a guest lecturer. As a operational partner, they have different activity like they will provide us physical infrastructure, training deployment, candidate mobilization, and other residency facility for the students. Yeah, this is a this slide about the training process. So initially, the first process like selection in the criteria like age group between 18 to 30 years and school dropouts or 8th class to 12th class IT or and IT or other class they can eligible for the this program. After the selection, they will go for a classroom training. This is a rigorous. They have 3 months classroom training with the practical and theory. In that, 80% practical for this training. After the 3 months training, they will go for 1 month OJT. Then there is a opportunity for them for the go for the job or become entrepreneur. This is the photographs of the our electrician training program center. Here we'll establish the advanced training lab for them. They will undergo all the practical training in this center. Such center we have, may I read mention, we have 280 centers across India with the 44 training partners. This training lab is a solar lab. We have 10 solar training centers across India. Out of 290, 10 is a solar training center. The eligibility is like this. After the electrician training program, those interested students, they can go for the solar training. Okay, this slide of impact of the programs, Schneider skill program. You can see the first person, few case that I attached here. Gurdip Singh is from the Mohali. He 12th pass and he completed his electrician training, one of the training center in Mohali. After the completion of his training, he got job, but after 9 months, he started his own company called GS Solar Enterprises. And he's earning 35,000 to 40K every month. And even he had given to job to 10 to 12 trained electricians also. These are the case studies. Like this case study shows the impact of the program. Because after skill program, maximum they'll offer the, they'll work as one electrician and a few for go for a job and few start, they'll start the own business. We even this skill program not for the male also. We had female candidate also. Till now we have trained nearly 3,800 female candidate trained as electricians. Okay, after the skill training, I had already mentioned they will go for job. They will work as one electrician. They will start the one business also. Okay, till now 303 trained electrician they started their own business. In the area of electrical and solar. You can see the breakup of this entrepreneur across India. Maximum entrepreneur in the Maharashtra and Karnataka and even Gujarat also. After here, our support is we will help them to improve their business with their, like product training and their shop branding and networking with the distributor. These things we used to provide them. Initially, after this, they will take it further. Okay, one of the good impact of this program is there are 12 trained entrepreneurs, they are provided employment to 92 electricians. This is good thing. They are starting business at the same time, they are providing job employment opportunity to other needy people also. Yeah, you can see the entrepreneur few case studies. His name is Jitendra Kumarwar. he started his business 2019. He is one of the distributor of Luminous. He's earning last year revenue was 2.5 million euros, million rupees. He had given employment to two trained electricians. Yeah, such like this, one of the guys from Rakesh Mishra is from Odisha and Maurish from the Maharashtra. They are quite well established after that training. Before the training, they are the school dropout. They're looking for job also. But after our training, they started their own business. Nikhil Munjal, one of the best case studies. He had trained in Bangalore. He is from Maharashtra. He completed his solar training in one of the training part in Bangalore. And he installed more than 50 solar system in last 3 months. His turnover was 5 lakhs rupees. This study of Monu Rawat is from UP. This all of case study shows that impacted the program. Not only Schneider is working for the skill training, we have other areas like I mentioned, we are in education scholarship for the engineer students and environment program for consumer planet is for school children. And we have electrification program, emergency and entrepreneurship development. This is all about our skill and entrepreneurship program. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Prashant. And friends, Mr. Prashant Shetty is a passionate development professional. He has been working with Schneider Electric since over 12 years, where he has played an important role in skills development program for unemployment, youth planning and execution of CSR projects, community relations and strategic partnerships. Thank you so much, Prashant, sir, for this lovely presentation of yours.
Thank you.
Now, I would want to... Yeah, to welcome Shambhavi Jha from Sterlite Technologies. Project name is Jeevan Jyoti Women Empowerment Program. Shambhavi is development professional committed to social development through fundraising, business development, and corporate communication. Shambhavi carrying out responsibilities like selection of NGO partners, due diligence, evaluating proposals, implementation of projects, and monitoring and evaluation. She has worked with prominent organizations like Gujarat State Fertilizers and Chemicals, Kirloskar Brothers, and currently working as CSR Manager at Sterlite Technologies. We welcome you, Shambhavi. You can continue with your story.
Thank you, Shweta, for such a lovely introduction. Namaste to all jury members and all the audience present today evening. So I'll be quickly sharing my screen. Manoj and Shweta, I just want you to give a heads up when you see my screen. So I am sharing my screen. Okay. Is my screen visible to all?
Yes, we can see.
All right. So I will quickly
start. It is not
start.
PPT, it is just screen we can see.
Folder you have to open.
You have to open your PPT first.
My PPT is open at my end. Can you see it now, the presentation?
No, the same screen. We can see the same screen.
Shambhavi, what you have to do is you have to click on, stop the sharing and then again try to share the whole screen. When it asks you to select what you want to share, select the full screen and then press on next.
All right. Okay.
Now click on the share screen. Then you will see a choice to select, different.
Yeah, I see the screen. So shall I go on sharing the screen or the screen which I have to share?
No, share the full screen. That would be much better. Shambhavi, we are not able to hear you.
Her video is paused, I guess.
Oh, network issue. There seems to be a network issue. The screen is frozen. Let's see if...
Manoj, if you could just message her.
Screen?
Yeah, she is there.
Okay.
Anush, can you share the screen from your end?
Yeah,
that would be better. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Manoj. So here quickly, I will introduce Jeevan Jyoti Women Empowerment Program. So it is a women empowerment program of Sterlite Technologies Limited. This program was started in 2014 with aim to empower women in a community which is mostly deprived of education, where we find more school dropout women who do not have provision for their further studies. So with this aim, we started Jeevan Jyoti Women Empowerment Program in 2014. Next slide. So all our projects at Sterlite is surrounded by UN Global Compact, 10 principles, and also SDG. So we can quickly skip the slides, Manoj. Yes, so this is the impact slides. Now we have covered around 1.32 lakhs of beneficiaries over the past 6 years. We have taken up around 4,18,000 health initiatives. We have impacted lives around 76,000 through environment interventions and EdTech 81,000. Just go ahead. Yes. So this is our aim for next 5 years, to impact 5 million lives, to reach out to 5 million people, and to have 5 million plants planted. Just go ahead. Manoj, please go to the next slide. Yeah. The next slide. Yeah. So now I will, for next couple of minutes, I'll be speaking primarily about Jeevan Jyoti Women Empowerment Program. So this program was started in order to address issues like gender disparity, where literacy was always an issue. And there has always been a lack of women education when it comes to a mainstream education. There is always a low connectivity. Almost 70% of the village is not connected to the road or conveyance, and they do not have any mode of transportation. And their health is always an issue. And agriculture, the area is mostly dependent on agriculture. As many of you would know that Maharashtra is a state which is mostly drought hit, and any community which is dependent 80% of agriculture is always a red flagger there. So it was a responsibility to come up with an alternate livelihood opportunity for women over there. So with this aim in 2014, this institute was started. And when we started with 6 courses. Manoj, come to the next slide. So 6 courses were started, and which was primarily in beauty culture, tailoring and cutting, fashion designing, and computer literacy, and 1 year program of nursing. So we found that after having these education or completing these certificate courses, many women were entrepreneurial enough to go ahead and start their something of their own in as a social enterprises. So we found a great shift in having more of social enterprises and small home-based businesses, where women started their own beauty parlors after doing this course. And after completion of the computer courses, they were again a part of a small offices. They started working in gas connection agencies. They started working in government offices. So these were the little changes which we were seeing after starting these courses. Manoj, you can keep on skipping courses, slides after every 30 seconds. Yes. So we have tied up with Maharashtra State Board of Vocational Education Training, and we have experienced set of qualified teachers who take these courses. And these courses are also widely recognized. And best part, during COVID, what we realized that these courses were not at halt, because women were so enterprising that they said that they are okay to go up, they are okay to start with the online training session. And this is what helped us and motivated us enough to start a digital education program for them. And we started conducting sessions through Google Hangouts. We started conducting sessions for WhatsApp. So this is how we kept on the momentum of the education in our center. Just ahead. Yeah, so these are some of the pictures which you can see. Yes. So along with that, we also focus more on employee volunteering and mentoring. So we have a pool of volunteers in STL who love to conduct volunteering opportunities for our women at Jeevan Jyoti Center. They skill these women in soft skill, English speaking courses, finance related training. They also help these women in starting a bank account or helping them understand a basic finances, which is important in day-to-day lives. Just go ahead. Keep going ahead. Yeah, so these are some of the pictures of our employee volunteering thing, which you can see. So our employee volunteering activity at STL is called Saksham. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So now I would like to talk about program highlights. So over the period of time, we have impacted 2,200 women already. And we have reached out to 11,300 lives, and total villages covered is 100. So we have almost students coming from 100 neighboring villages, which is low on connectivity and transport and conveyance. And 970 women have already been benefited by the health camps, which we provide each year. Along with that, we started additional projects, which would help women to have more of social enterprises. So we started, we partnered with nodal agency called MAVIM. It's a Maharashtra state nodal agency, which formed 50 SHGs with 723 women. And the primary focus of having SHGs is to have more and more social enterprise to train women in whatever they feel comfortable in. Like, if they are comfortable in starting something which is agriculture allied activities, we would be going ahead and training them in that and helping them establish business as something in which they are already comfortable doing in, rather than bringing something to the table which they do not know. So with this aim, we started this project. And today we can proudly say that average income of all our SHG members, including our students who are graduated from Jeevan Jyoti Women Empowerment Center, they are able to earn anywhere between 2,000 to 15,000 per month. Along with that, we have also helped around 50 with microfinance amount of 55 lakhs, which was disposed in 20 SHGs to start their own businesses and invest in upskilling their business or start something totally new from the scratch. Just go to the next slide, Manoj. Yeah. So this is the case study. Like you can see, like in the left, this is a girl. Like she was married and came to the village where she was dreaming to come be part of a mainstream education, which of course didn't happen for quite some time. Then with Jeevan Jyoti, she learned about Jeevan Jyoti. She came to the center, she completed her education over there, and she started her own tailoring and cutting or something, a tailoring business from her own home. So this is one example. Like in second box, you can see that again, she wanted to do something in hospitality sector where she came, she learned nursing in our institute. And when she went back, she became part of a main hospitality sector. So she clearly says that Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, she resonates loudly with this thing. So come to the next slide. Yeah, so these are our partners. Just one slide. Yeah. So these are our potential partners of our project. MSBVV, that is Maharashtra State Board of Vocational Education. Rangasutra is a production house partner. So last year, we also started training. As I said, that this area, this catchment area is 80% dependent on agriculture, and Maharashtra is always drought hit. And this is a red flag for us. So we started training women in advanced handicrafts. Like we started training women in block print, we started training women in advanced stitching and also embroidery so that they can have an alternate livelihood altogether. And also we are helping them strongly with the market linkages. For that, we have tied up with Amazon Saheli. Amazon Saheli is a e-commerce platform where these women can sell their products online. And in just 3 months, I'm very proud to say that just in 3 months, women were able to sell to fulfill around 20 orders and to reach out to 14 different states in within just three months span of time. So that was a great success for us. And along with that, I already mentioned earlier that we are partnered with MAVIM, which is a state nodal agency for Maharashtra government. Come to the next slide. Yeah. So this is just the reach we have been we have had in over 6 years. So you see, like, we have been increasing almost every year. And with this, we have also introduced our SHG project. So you see that we have reached to 8 villages and formed additional 8 villages and formed 50 SHGs with 723 members. Come to the next slide. So with this, I would end my presentation. As I mentioned that we have taken 20 orders from across 14 states, and we have been working really very hard to train all our women in advanced crafts. And to end with, I would say that when this pandemic struck, our women were on foot, and we right after 1 week of when the lockdown was announced, our women took up the opportunity to stitch around 20,000 masks. So everybody came up, they tried their level best, and they kept on working hard. And even during COVID times, I can proudly say that our women did not let us stop the training, because that was the power of digital platform. Like, they were taking trainings online, they were practicing from home. And now in September, we would be again receiving our first retail order from Ranga Sutra. So with this, I end my presentation. Thank you all.
Thank you, Shambhavi. It was a wonderful presentation, and kudos to the ladies, those who really worked hard at the time of COVID. And I could see so many questions popping up for, especially for you. And so we later on take up those questions. So we had Ms. Shambhavi Jha from Sterlite Technologies. Now we have our next guest, Mr. Anthony Nalesari. Project name is Satya Bharati School and from Bharati Foundation. Good evening, sir. Mr. Anthony is an educationist, coach, and social development professional with 2 decades of experience in education management, leadership development, community development, project implementation, program management, and training and development. He is currently the chief of school excellence. Prior to this, he has worked with Save the Children as project director and head of operations at Educom Solutions, and he is an alumnus of IRMA. Good evening, sir. We welcome you, and here is your platform. You can start with your story.
I hope you are able to see. Good evening, everyone. I hope you are able to see my presentation.
Yes, sir. It is visible.
Okay. I think it has started with the last slide. Sorry about that. So as it's been already introduced, thank you for the introduction. And it's going to be a tough time for me to be one of the last presenters with such a good presentation that has gone through before me already. So Bharati Foundation, which was launched in 2000 as a philanthropic arm of Bharati Group of Enterprises with a motto of transforming India one village at a time. The school that you see, the photo that you see on the top, is the primary elementary school that we have established in the rural villages in 6 states of India, in a land donated by Panchayat, and we have constructed, and we are running free education in these villages. The photo that you see is the senior secondary school that we have in public-private partnership with the government of Punjab. So the main focus of this presentation is the Satya Bharati School program and its impact that we are looking at it. As you see, we are having presently 183 schools, and we are mainly looking at the primary school education. We are in 6 states of India, reaching almost close to 40,000 children, of which 50% are girls, children with us. We focus quite a bit on girl child education. And some of the key features are, it is completely rural based, and all the facilities and welfare activities that are required for our students are completely free of cost. And we focus especially on the girl children. And we also have a vocational education program in our senior secondary school. And our teachers are recruited from the local community, where we focus more on developing the local resources so that economy grows into the villages rather than going out of the villages. Just like any of the normal good schools, which you see in any private school in the cities, we have tried to bring in all those key activities and facilities that are required for the children to develop their skills and hone their character and values. And so we work on the holistic development of the children through various means that we have given to them. One of the other key features of our program is we give a lot of importance to the engagement of parents and community in our program. And so once in a year, we give 3 to 4 days of our schooling system. We hand it over to the parents and community members. The key artisans of the villages or the nearby villages come into the school and start teaching about what they themselves, what they are doing. And it's another way of not only improving the community connect with the students, but also giving them various trades and also giving them a mutual respect for the students and the elders in the family, in the villages. And one of the photos that I would like to take your attention is on the bottom, on the right, extreme on the right, you will find some of the parents sitting and studying. This was an impact of one of the children in West Bengal started teaching his parents, who are not literate, started teaching them. And when we realized this is something which we realized anybody can do this at our school level. So all the children who are class 4 and above, they have been given now as a holiday homework to teach the parents or grandparents who are illiterate to make them literate. As of now, in the last 3-4 years, we have already crossed more than 20,000 adults who are made literate by the children who are studying in our school. This is one of the study that has been done by Change Alliance. Earlier it was done by ENY study. This is a recent study that is there. What we felt is, as part of the key findings from the study, there's a good delta of improvement in our children compared to the children in the nearby schools or similar schools, whether it is in terms of communication, their confidence, and share of belonging with the others. And they also have a very different way of accepting the mistakes and giving them positive conciliatory actions. Some of the impact on the parents and communities are on the slide, but the key features again, how parents have been able to engage with the school was one of the key findings, and how parents have ensured all the girls' children are taken into the next level for studies. When we look at the alumni, when we have the alumni meet almost on an annual basis, we realize all the children who come into the school, 98% are continuing education, and all girl children are studying, continuing their education. That's something good that we feel proud about. So what we are looking at in Satyabharti School is how it can help the social change apart from the education, how they can develop their employability skills and make sure our alumni does better and better. And I'll just give you some stories of how children have become social agents of change. This is an example which I've already told you about, role reversal through education to an adult literacy program, which is also helping them to reaffirm their own learnings, what they have learned in their school education program. This is another impact that has happened. More than 33 children were saved from child marriages, especially the girls in place of Rajasthan. This is another, many of these stories have been awarded as part of Design for Change, is a national award for village development or a student-led movement. This is another place where they have defeated the Thar, the desert. They have been completing the plantation drive. This is another example for where they have started. These are started by students who are studying in our school, not necessarily it is initiated by Bharti Foundation. This is one of the examples where students have set up book clubs so that they can continue the reading habit even after school hours, whether it is in the newspaper or the books. We have started in the year 2000, but the school program was started in 2006. Now we have completed 14 years. Now we have started getting the alumni stories coming in. Many of our students have started joining army. They've started doing us proud by getting into the colleges. And as I said earlier, 98% are continuing into our education system. And we also find that some of them want to come back and become teachers in our own school program. And the campaign, various campaigns that we have in our system has helped to change the villages. There is one campaign that was sent, made by the children, has helped in transforming the mindset of the villages, in bringing down the substance abuse. This is one another instance where the children have put an end to use of drugs during milking by the villages. This is another second example. On the bottom of the slide, you will find how children have found out separate another route to make sure their movement to the school is safe. I can go on giving you more stories, but the main story I would like to say the impact is how the learning of Satya Bharati School has helped in increasing the impact by supporting the larger education system in the country, that is government school system. We started with a pilot of 8 schools in 2 states. Now we are working in 804 schools in 14 states. This is another program that we are running in the government schools where we have made 15 blocks of 2 states out of school children free. This program was to mainstream the out of school children, dropouts, never enrolled children into the government school with a bridge course. And the program that I was talking about, government school, that's 804 schools, 14 states, and we are reaching more than 230,000 students with 15% girls. And we are working on how various stakeholders like students, teachers, parents can be engaged so as to improve the quality of education in the school. This is another study that we have done on the impact of the program in government school, government schools, and we find that the students are taking ownership of their own activities, their own learning process. We also find impact on teachers in terms of they have started changing the methodology of teaching in their own school based on the various efforts that has been made by our own academic mentors who are going and visiting the schools. We also find that the school environment has been completely transformed. We are not supporting any construction of any of the schools. However, because of the various activities that has been completed, whether it is in terms of library, whether it is science labs, sports ground, everything has been activated. Many of the government schools in the country where we had gone, initially it had been very active in the library, not too much active in the labs. This is something which has been activated. These are some of the examples of various key awards that has been won by our children, and it has been going on increasing on the day go by. And with regard to the government school, the participation has been very difficult. Now, not only the participation has increased, it's also increased the number of awards. This is another example of from a government school setup where some of the children have started becoming RJ during the break, during the government schools, and trying to improve their communication skills and other writing and reading skills during this particular program. And it's another initiative that has also won a national award. This is the other various examples for making sure it is not only clean, it's also a green. This is another program with which I would like to end. This is a program that we have done as part of the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan as part of the national program. And we have practically made ODF in two districts of Rajasthan. You can see the statistics on the slide. And overall, if I can say that we have touched upon more than 2 million families and members in the villages, more than 400,000 students, and we have covered more than 25,000 schools since inception. So thank you very much. I think I will end here and my 10 minutes are also over.
थैंक यू सो मच मिस्टर एंटनी, एंड आपकी बात सुन के मुझे ये लाइन याद आती है कि पढ़ेगा भारत तभी तो आगे बढ़ेगा भारत, एंड लाइन्स फॉर एवरीबडी, ऑल द जूरी मेंबर्स, द स्टोरी टेलर्स एंड देयर व्यूअर्स. ये सुन के ही मैं कितनी इंस्पायर्ड हूँ, मोटिवेटेड हूँ. आई मीन आई जस्ट कैनॉट टेल यू, बट देयर इज वन लाइन फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू.